Good, we're back. We're going to calculate position and velocity given the acceleration vector. As I said, we're going to work in reverse. Now, at least for these parts, next few parts in these lectures, I'm not going to do explicit coding. By that I mean the lines of code that you can write that will do all of this for you. I'm rather going to make use of these images here to explain the physics behind things. Definitely later we're going to do the sympy.physics.mechanics library, and you can see you can do most of these things with lines of code. So I'm going to use sparse amounts of code. You can see there's some down here just to explain stuff, but so yeah, I would never use this code to solve this kind of problem. But let's go. So imagine you're given this acceleration vector. You can see it's a vector in 3 space. The x of t would be 6t, the y of t would be 12t plus 2, and the z of t would be e to the power t. So that what that describes is an acceleration vector. So at every point in time, for different values of t, an acceleration vector is going to change. It'll change in magnitude and it'll change in direction. We are also given the velocity as far as an initial velocity vector. Time equals 0, we have this velocity vector pointing in the direction 2, 0, 1. And we're also given an initial position vector, 0, 3, 5. So that's at time equals 0, we have that. Now we asked, can you calculate a velocity vector, which will be a vector in 3 space, with so it'll have 3 sections as well, each containing the variable t. Can you do that? Now, we are using the sympy.physics.vector library here, and it does have a .div. Remember, we could say vector.diff, and with respect to what variable and in what reference frame, but there's not a .integrate function. So we have to do this, at least if I use this type of code, the long way around. So what I've done here is I've introduced these three computer variables, a underscore x, a underscore y, and a underscore z. And you can see there as 6 times t, which is the 6t up there, the 12 times t plus 2 up there, and the e to the power t up there. So I've introduced that. And now I can use the integrate function. Now this is part of sympy, not part of the sympy.physics.vector library. It's part of the normal sympy library, so I can just use it because I imported from sympy import integrate right at the top at the beginning of this lecture 4. So again, I'm making these three computer variables, velocity x, velocity y, and velocity z. You could call them whatever you want, and all I have to say is integrate, and then the expression I want to integrate, a underscore x is 6 times t, comma, what I want to integrate with respect to. The same for y and the same for z. Now this is going to give you an indefinite integral without the constant coefficient. You have to just put in that constant coefficient yourself. Beware though, here we are dealing with vectors. It's not going to be a constant coefficient for an indefinite integral. It's going to be a constant vector. C is now going to be a vector, not just a constant of integration. So let's go. So I now have vx, vy, and vz, and if I just print that to the screen, and you know the indefinite integral of 6t would be 3t squared, and there you go. So if I just, there's vx, I'm just printing it to the screen. The indefinite integral of 12 times t plus 2 is going to be 6t squared plus 2t, and the indefinite integral of e to the power t would just be e to the power t. So just to bring the point home, I'm just going to just show you here the an image of what it now looks like. We have the v of t, and for vx, vy, and vz, there it is, 3t squared, 6t squared plus 2t, and e to the power t plus c with a line under it. That is now a constant vector. And I have to figure out what that constant vector is. And we do it in the following way. Remember, we were given the initial velocity vector, v at 0. So if I take this v of t and I plug in 0 for every t, which is what I've done here, 3 times 0 squared, 6 times 0 squared plus 2 times 0 and e to the power 0, plus this constant coefficient should equal this initial velocity vector that I was given, 2, 0, 1. Remember up there, we were given the initial velocity, 2, 0, 1, and there we have 2, 0, 1. Remember, this is a constant vector c, so it has three components in the x, y, and z direction, or otherwise the I, j, and k direction, whichever way you want to call it. Well, let's do this. 3 times 0 squared is just 0. 6 times 0 squared plus 2 times 0 is just 0. E to the power 0 is 1. So I can simplify this bit as 0, 0, 1, plus that should give me 2, 0, 1. Now, remember how to do vector addition. We just sum the individual components. So it will be a 0 plus this c in the I direction, 0 plus c in the j direction, and 1 plus c in the k direction. So I'm just simplifying this addition here. So that should give me 2, 0, 1. So we have that. C in the I direction is going to equal 2, C in the J direction equals 0, and C in the K direction plus 1 equals 1. In other words, if I take that negative 1 to the other side, C in the K direction is 0. So now I have solved CI, CJ, CK is 2, 0, 0. That is 2, 0, 0. That is my constant vector. So finally, I can get my velocity vector. It's going to be 3t squared plus 2, so it's that 3t squared plus 2, the 6t squared plus 2t plus 0, and e to the power t plus 0. So there I have solved, because I was given the initial conditions, initial vector at v at time equals 0, I can solve for this constant vector. So if you do integration of a vector, you sit, and it's an indefinite integral, as we had up here, then most definitely that is going to be C with a line under it. It is a vector, and you have to write it in its component form there to solve this problem. And the very same thing, I haven't done it here, will go for the position vector. You're going to do it in exactly the same. So given an initial acceleration vector, I can integrate it to get the velocity vector, which I can integrate again to get the position vector. Just remember that you have the constant vector of integration there when you do integrate vectors.